Hi, welcome to PharmacyG.net. In this tutorial, we are going to create the particle instance scene within Blender. And this is the scene file. If you watched my previous tutorial, we just created this bottle and some lighting effects. If you don't know about this, and you can see here in my YouTube channel PharmacyG, you can see a lot of tutorials about Blender and some dynamic titling Blender tutorials, some titling and some cloth and some rendering effect. And here is the video we are going to create, and this is the bottle modeling tutorial, and this is the studio lighting tutorial. We just need two of this, and if you are interested, you can just use add some static bottle and some real fluid simulation in Blender. So we are just going to create our actual scene. So this is actual scene file. I just separated it with the lighting itself, and this is the bottle itself. And in the next layer, we are going to create the RBCs for the particle instancing. So I'm just going to add a mesh and a UV sphere here. So this will be going to our primitive RBCs. Just keep the default value here, just use smooth and press S for scaling, then press Z and scale it in Z axis like this. Okay, so we have some kind of effect like this, and we need to create some concave shape for this RBC, because the actual RBC have a concave shape at its surface. So in the edit mode, press A, deselect everything, and select deselect everything, and in the vertex mode, select the top and bottom vertices, and you need to turn on this proportional editing. Just turn on enable and press S for scaling, then press Z for scaling the Z axis. Just scroll your mouse like this and scroll your middle mouse button to increase the scaling area. So we will get some nice looking RBC like this. So we just have an RBC. Just in the object mode, rename it to RBC, and I'm just going to save the scene as save as. I have a lot of file here. I'm just going to use class bottle RBC mesh dudes. So this is going to be our instancer for the particle. So first of all, we need to create some sort of texturing to it or a material to it. Just turning on our lighting and in the rendered mode, see what's happening. Now we have a white grid. Just going to turn off my square sample, so rendering will be very fast. And one more thing, if you see, I'm just using the version 2.691, and it is not that officially available for download. It is released from Blender SVN build, and we need to change the texturing itself. So go to the shading material mode, add a new material, rename it to RBC, and also we just going to use a mixed shader, and the first shader should be an emission shader, and the strength should be 0.25, and the color will be pure red. So choose a red color. The second shader should be a velvet BSDF, so that will mix with our primary emission shader, and the color should be the red just created. Sorry, just zero. Okay, an RBC but it is not the actual shading. We need some kind of subsurface scattering like effect. I'm not using any subsurface material here. We already have a subsurface scattering material, but I'm just going to use another technique here. In the factor, you can see it is 0.5. If I just decrease it to 0, it will use the full emission, and if I use 1, it will use an actual relevant shader itself. So we are going to play with this area, that is the factor area. Click on this button and add a facing. So that will add a facing node. So we will get some sort of effect like this. You can see, and now it will behave like this. And if you want, you can play with the scene value itself, like reorder this emission and velvet BSDF. So maybe in the node editor you can see what are these nodes here. Don't need the tool shelf, I'm just going to delete. Okay, so we have like this layer weight, blend value, and facing like this. And if I just do the opposite, you can have some kind of effect like this. Maybe this is the effect I just want. So this is the actual effect we just need. So this is the actual effect I just need. I just misplaced the area. So this shader, it should be, the emission should be the second shader, and the velvet should be the first shader. And you need to change the value back to 0.5, so you will get a less lighting. So go back to our actual property tab. See, so our first shader will be the velvet and the second shader will be the emission. So we have our RBC, and going to solid mode, just say once again. Okay, so we need to add some particles in order to RBC to float. So I'm going to add a mesh and a circle. Press D to bring back tool shelf, and you can see there is a fill type. I just select that and just use ncan, so that will fill. And in the front view, I'm just going to front view, just make sure you just place just inside this portal itself like this, and maybe a little bit higher, and scale it little down so it just fit inside our bottle. And also rename it to an RBC emitter. Rename it to an RBC emitter. So we have an RBC emitter like this. And also we need to turn on particle system. Rename it to RBC particles. Also change the number to 300 and also the lifetime value to 125. You can just use a random of 5, and start and end value should be 200. You can increase it if you want. And there's something legit to random, don't change anything like here. And one more thing, you need to select the cache value and just turn the cache steps to to 1. And also the normal should be 1. And in the rotation tab, turn on the rotation, and you should be use the velocity here itself and the angular velocity to random, and turn on dynamic and also 2 for the random value. Okay, we we don't need to change anything here, but in the size deflect, the force under force tab, just turn on the size deflect, and also in the render tab, turn off the emitter, and in the field weight settings, turn down the gravity to zero, and just play the scene. You can see now our particles are floating upward. We need to use the airbases for instances. Before that, I'm going to turn this to be a collider. So select our boat tail itself and go to the physics tab and a collision. Okay, so we just have a collision object and our emitter. Select the RBC emitter itself and go to the particle settings itself under the object of the render tab. You can see there is hello. Now it said hello. You can select the object itself and select RBC. So that will add our RBC to the particle itself. And now you can see it's just simply rotating and colliding with object. And if you want, you can, now it's uniformly scaled. If you want, you can just use a random size. So simply turn this and you can see a random size, and just increase the size a little bit higher. You can see what is happening, okay, like this. So it is a little bit higher, exaggerated for, and just see what's happening inside that. So just make sure you just play the whole scene itself, and before finishing to the 250, just click the pause button and just save the scene. And here at the disk cache value, that is the cache step, just do a cache name for that, and just using bc inst particles, select the disk cache. It will take a while to turn on, just wait for. You have two options. If you just created the memory cache, you can see the red value to the end of this section. You can just use current cache to back. If you just failed to stop at the value, you can just use the back itself, or just use the current cache to back, and that will be the faster option. So you have now your cached option to be saved to the actual disk. Now you can make a rendering for this. I'm just moving it to another layer so we can see what is happening. So now just turn on that, just in the rendered mode, see what is happening. So now we have our RBCs itself, and just you turn on our bottle. So this concludes the tutorial, and you can see one more settings, and now you can see now our RGB is a little bit darker here because of this glass. So, and this is the problem with the actual velvet shader. You will have dark rendering. For me, if you have something like a glass, thick glass object like this, so you can just increase your RBC materials, the emission strength, you can just increase it whatever you want. So this will add some more lighting to your RBC. If you want to add something known for race or some epic like effect, so the actual RBC or whatever object inside this area to be shown brighter, you can just increase as much as you want. So now in the value of 1, you can see a brighter RBC. So actually this will enhance your rendering. So if you just use the velvet shader, you need to add more lighting inside the bottle to create some effect like this. So this concludes this tutorial. So keep watching FermiCG.net, and also remember to subscribe to our FermiCG YouTube channel and visit www.fermicg.net for more information and scene file.